you go, so basically you just gonna be the color commentator. All you gotta do is just like, you know, chime in and tell whether you think people are taking bad shots, what they need to do to win, stuff like that. I'll do the play-by-play.
Here we go, y'all. Here we go. Phoenix versus South Shore, game one of 13 this weekend.
Hello, 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 and welcome to another broadcast of Hoops High. I'm your play-by-play for the day, Dalen Jeffries, and I'm joined with Amari Willis, who will be our color commentator.
Chase Lewis.
Taking the floor for the first game in our Jimmy Sanders and Sean Harrington Hoops High Hall of Fame shootout, we have Varsity Phoenix Military Academy versus South Shore. Should be a pretty exciting game today.
Number 4, E. Fox.
Phoenix Military comes into today's game 2-0 after coming off an exciting overtime win last night. So, two games in 2 days, looking to stay undefeated. South Shore is 0-2 so far this season, so they're hoping to get their first win this year.
South Shore from the south side. Number 11, J. Lewis. Number 3, P. Williams. Number 12, T. Jones. Number 32.
And if you don't already know, be sure to catch Hoops High every Saturday at 8 p.m. on Channel 19. Again, that's Hoops High every Saturday at 8 p.m. on Channel 19, CAN TV.
Number 2, T. Jones. South Shore in the white home team. Phoenix in the black away team. Here we go, game one.
So, Amari, looking at these two teams and they're about to take the floor, what do you think Phoenix needs to do to get the W today?
This is the Jimmy Sander.
What do you think Phoenix should do to get the W?
Play good defense. Don't take bad shots.
There you have it. Phoenix needs to keep their defensive intensity up so they can come out with the win. And we're off. South Shore wins the tip. Number 2 passes to number 3 on the perimeter down to the post. Little give and go action blocked by number 24 of the Phoenix going down court.
We got Greg Boyle with the ball right here, averaging 30 points a game.
Senior captain Greg Boyle
so far.
Picks the ball up.
Averaged 30 last year.
On the wing, dribbles to the top of the
key. With the ball.
He is their senior captain, averaging a little over 30 points per game this year. Boyle gets it back,
big
passes
fella
to the post. And we have a foul call. Number 24, Khalid Heron, will step to the free throw line, shooting 2. Heron hits the first to give Phoenix the early lead. Misses the second, rebound goes to number 11 of South Shore. Mid-range jump shot up, bounces around, and is good. South Shore with a 2-1 lead on the bucket from number 2. Phoenix with the motion offense, passing the ball around the top of the key as they work against the 2-3 zone of South Shore. Long 3 misses, rebound to number 11 of South Shore. We're going back the other way. Baseline pass stolen by number 4 of the Phoenix. Traveling call, turnover on number 4. So he gets the steal, then turns the ball right over. Just a Mr. mistake right there. Ball is inbounded to number 3 of South Shore. Number two with the long three, misses. Rebound to Phoenix, going back down court. Heron bringing the ball across half for the Phoenix. Takes it all the way to the cup, dishes out for the mid-range two, and it's good. Heron picks up the assist as number five for the Phoenix, knocks it down. South Shore gets their offense going with Howden defense from the Phoenix. And the Phoenix knocked the ball loose, and South Shore will inbound it on the side. And it's still early in the season, so neither one of these teams has been able to get a lot of recruiting on the other. So it sure makes for a lot of game with not a lot of game plan. So hopefully you're tuning in and you're enjoying this exciting action. Number 23 to the basket, and it is blocked by Heron of the Phoenix. And South Shore will inbound the ball from the baseline. Number 11 works against the defense, passes to the top of the key. They swing the ball around. Pick and roll action at the top. Number two with the bounce pass, stolen, but goes out of bound, and South Shore retains possession. Phoenix steals the inbound pass, and they're off to the fast break. The ball is stolen right back by South Shore, and we have a jump ball here with 5 minutes left. South Shore is trailing by one to the Phoenix. Phoenix inbounds the ball after winning the jump ball call. And there's a long three from number one. It misses. Offensive rebound stolen by South Shore. South Shore works against the man defense. Foul is called on Heron of the Phoenix. And number 11 goes to the line, shooting his first free throws of the night. Number 11 shoots the first, no good. Score remains 3-2 in favor of the Phoenix with 4:48 remaining here in the first quarter. Number 11 misses the second shot, but will get a third due to the violation on Phoenix. Number 11 with his third shot on the violation, and he sinks it. Now we have a tie game here at three as Phoenix brings the ball up across half, and they get their offense going. Long three from number one of the Phoenix, rims in and out, and it gets his own rebound, passes to number five. And the bucket's good. So number one misses the long three, but stays with it, gets the rebound and the assist to give Phoenix a 5-3 lead. Screen and roll by South Shore. Ball is swung around the perimeter. Number 23 with the mid-range pull-up. No good. And we're headed back down court. Phoenix with the ball. And they pull it back out. Slow the ball up. Number four, point guard for the Phoenix, swings it back up top as they look to work the ball down low. Number one with another three, still no good. He's missed all three of his long shots here tonight. Maybe he needs to take a little step in. Heron picks up his second foul on the other end as number 11 goes back to the line, shooting two. Thank you. And you are watching Hoops High. We are at Collins Academy for the Jimmy Sanders and Sean Harrington shootout. And right now we have South Shore taking on the Phoenix for the first varsity game of the day. Coming up next, we will have Lynn Bloom and Clark take the floor. And we should have a good day of games here. Lynn Bloom and Clark will be our next game, followed by Lincoln Park and Hope Academy. So get to Collins Academy if you want to see some really good basketball. Number one with another three for the Phoenix. He misses it again. Offensive rebound to the Phoenix, and it is brought back out as they reset their offense. Another three, no good, but we have a foul on the three, so he will go to the line. Number five for the Phoenix, shooting three. And the first free throw is no good. And he hits the second with the third and final free throw coming up now. Number five misses two of three as South Shore rebounds the ball and they head back up court. Wide open layup for number 11 and it's good as South Shore goes up 7-6 with 2:45 left here in the first quarter. The 2-3 zone from South Shore keeps the ball on the perimeter for the Phoenix on the offensive end. What? Ball is passed to the post, swung back out, long three for number one, and he knocks it down, his first triple of the night. And Hoops High is produced by high school students who are all learning the skills of professional broadcasting. All the camera work, announcing, directing, and engineering is done by the students as he misses that layup but gets his own rebound. South Shore brings it back out. With the screen up top by number 11. Ball is passed to the post. And we have a traveling violation on South Shore. Phoenix possession. Number five with the long three for Phoenix. It rims out. South Shore rebounds it. And they're off to the fast break. Number 11 with the easy layup that he misses. Rebounded by number 23. Long three from number one. He misses, but he refuses to stop shooting, although he's only made one today. Long pass back out to the top of the key as Phoenix resets their offense. And they pass the ball into the post. He dribbles out, swings it across court. Number one with another three. No good. Out of bounds to South Shore. Forty-seven seconds remaining here as Phoenix hangs on to a two-point lead. Pass to number four, who comes off the curl, stolen by the Phoenix, and they're off to the races. Pass is deflected, and it will stay Phoenix ball. Ball is inbounded by the Phoenix number one. Dribbling, swings it across court. Number two with the long three, can't get it. Number one gets it, three, no good. Rebounded by South Shore. Number four passes the ball up court to number 11. Loses the ball out of bounds. Phoenix ball. 12 seconds remaining here in the first. Phoenix will hold for the last shot of the corner. Ball is swung across court. Number one with the fadeaway three. Misses. And at the end of the first, Phoenix Military Academy leads South Shore 9-7. So, Mari, after that first quarter, what did you see from South Shore that they could improve on going into the second quarter?
They had good offense. They passed the ball around. They won stand. South Shore needs to come back with their mom defense. They lacking on defense and they turning the ball over.
And I think you said it best. South Shore needs to control the ball just a little bit better. They got a lot of petty turnovers there in the first quarter. So hopefully they can tighten up and regain the lead. And again, we are here at Collins Academy for the Jimmy Sanders, Sean Harrington Hall of Fame shootout. We'll be here all day, so feel free to stop by and check out some great high school games here at Collins Academy. South Shore will inbound the ball to start the second quarter from the side. Ball is inbounded and the second quarter kicks off with South Shore bringing it up. Stolen by number 23 of the Phoenix. Phoenix works their motion offense. Number one to the basket, misses the layup. Offensive rebound, number 24 with the putback. South Shore with the screen up top. Foul on number one of the Phoenix with the reach. South Shore with the sub. Number 12 enters the game, replacing number 23 of South Shore. And the inbound pass is stolen by number one, who takes it all the way but misses the layup. South Shore comes back the other way. Number 12, shot is blocked by number 23 of the Phoenix. Number 24 pushing the ball up, big man point guard. 24 gets the ball in the post, he looks to work something. Ball is stolen by South Shore. Number 12 passes out to number two at the top of the key of South Shore. Ball is worked to the high post, back to the wing. Number 12 takes it all the way. Foul is on number one of the Phoenix, who picks up his second foul in less than a minute. And number 12 shoots two. First shot is up and a little short off the front of the rim. And here comes the second shot from South Shore. He misses that too, and the rebound goes to the Phoenix as number two pushes it up. Long two from the Phoenix, missed. They get their own rebound though, but step on the line, and the ball is going down to South Shore. A lot of turnovers here early in the game. Neither team is protecting the ball that well, and I think the team that protects the ball better going forward will come away victorious today. Number 11 has the ball in the wing, looking to operate. Passes to 32, who gives it up to number 12 of South Shore at the top of the key. Ball is worked around the perimeter as number two slashes to the basket. No good. Rebound to number four of the Phoenix, and 32 picks up the frustration foul. trying to defend off of the rebound. Phoenix brings the ball up as they hold on to a four-point lead here in the second quarter with 6 minutes remaining. The ball is worked into the post to number 24, who swings it across court to number two. Ball is worked back across court. And now number two with the head fake. Swings it to the corner. Long three, no good. South Shore gets the ball and they're off to the races. Number two slows it up, works it around the perimeter. Nice bounce pass to number 32. Misses the layup, but number 11 with the putback. Number 23 gets the ball in the high post. Ball is swung to number 4. And the ball is stolen by number 12 of South Shore, who goes all the way for the layup with the contact. Finishing through the contact. Nice move. Number 12 of South Shore to tie the game up. Pressure defense a little from South Shore. Long three from two, no good. Rebound goes to the Phoenix. Number 24 knocks down the three for the Phoenix, giving them the 14-11 lead with 4.5 minutes left here in the first half. Phoenix takes their first time out of the game. Despite number 24 being the big man, he's been the biggest facilitator for the Phoenix Redbirds here today. He's got 3 assists and 4 rebounds, but he's been running their offense from the post. So big man can pass the ball too.
Up next to the small gym, Lincoln Park versus Hope Academy Fossil. Up next to the small gym too.
South Shore brings the ball up off of the timeout as the Phoenix go to a full court press. South Shore wastes no time breaking the press. It slows it down to get their offense running. Phoenix looks to be in a man-to-man defensive scheme here, hoping to kind of speed up South Shore and force them into a few more turnovers. Blocking foul called on number 22 of the Phoenix. Ball to be inbounded on the side to South Shore. Ball is stolen by number 11 off the inbound, and he will take it all the way. Ball is deflected off of him, going down to South Shore. Nice defense by number 15 after allowing the steal. He gets it back, strips the ball, and forces a turnover. Coming up next in the Jimmy Sanders and Sean Harrington Hall of Fame shootout, we will have Lynn Bloom and Clark tipping up at 1 p.m. here at Collins Academy. Phoenix comes away with the steal off the, and the long three, it's good. 17-11, Phoenix up with 3:47 remaining in the first half. South Shore breaks the press of Phoenix, but they throw it away, and the ball is going down. Excuse me, looks like it was an inadvertent whistle. Ball to be inbounded to South Shore. Number two drives the baseline with the floater. No good. Rebounded by number 11, and it's good. Number 11 of South Shore has been a force on the glass so far here in the first half. Keeping his team in the game with his offensive rebounds and putbacks. South Shore with another steal going down. Number 2 slashes to the basket, gives it up to number 11, who makes a nice pass to a cutting point guard, but he's not able to finish at the basket. Number 24 of Phoenix with the and one after pushing a fast break all by himself. Point guard who? He steps to the line shooting one as he looks to give the Phoenix a 7-point lead with 3 minutes remaining. And number 24 gets the and one. Pass stolen by number 2 of the Phoenix for the easy layup as the Redbirds push their lead over South Shore to 9. South Shore breaks the press for the easy 2 by number 11. Timeout called by South Shore. 2:37 remaining here in the first as Phoenix Redbirds cling to a 7-point lead over South Shore. And Amari, you were just saying during the last possession that number 24 of the Phoenix has been a main player for those guys today.
Yes.
Looks like he's been able to do it all. He's been rebounding, passing, and knocking down some jump shots. And you can keep up with all the game action and all things Hoop High by following us on social media. You can search us on Facebook, Hoops High. You can also follow us on Twitter at Hoops High FSM. And be sure to check out our Hoops High YouTube channel to see some of our past games. Phoenix to inbound the ball. As they look to battle the full-court press of South Shore. Blocking foul called on number 15 as he trips number 4 of the Phoenix. South Shore has 4 fouls here in the first half, 2 Phoenix's 6. Ball is worked to the corner for the Phoenix. Number 24 swings it across court. Who touch passes to the corner. Long three missed, going down. Rebounded by number 12. Number 12 comes off the screen, picks up his dribble. South Shore slashes to the lane, misses the layup, but it's foul. Number 35 steps to the line, shooting 2. And with the minute 52 seconds remaining here in the first half, South Shore trails Phoenix Redbirds 22-15. He misses the 1-on-1, and the Phoenix are headed back down court. Timeout called by the Phoenix with 1:34 remaining in the first half. Coach didn't like what he saw from his offense, so looks like he's going to draw up a quick play. What up, Steve? Thank you. Phoenix inbounds the ball off of the timeout. And South Shore has been in the 2-3 zone so far this half, and it's worked pretty much. They forced a lot of long threes from the Phoenix, and they haven't been successful in hitting it. So if it's not broken, why fix it? The Redbirds continue to work the ball around the perimeter as they look for a good shot. Number 24 passes the ball to the corner. Pull-up jump shot by number 2, nothing but air. Offensive rebound to number 11. Long 3, fade away, no good. Jump ball called on the rebound. Number 24 and number 11 get tangled up. Phoenix to get the ball off the jump ball. Ball is passed in the corner to number 2, who swings it across court. Good ball movement by the Phoenix here. Number 24 with the 3. No good. Number 11 with the rebound. 30 seconds left as South Shore pushes it down court, looking to cut into the 7-point lead of the Phoenix. Ball is out of bounds to South Shore. Number 12 with a crossover and a pull-up jump shot. No good. Number 24 rebounds it. Stolen by number 32. Stolen right back by number 24. Oh, before the steal by number 24. It looks like a timeout to South Shore. 13.9 seconds left in the first half. 7-point lead for the Phoenix. Both teams are struggling here early on offense. It's been a field goal drop for the last 3 minutes. Only buckets that have come have been on free throws. So. South Shore inbounds the ball. Number 11 to the basket, misses the layup. Offensive rebound to South Shore, but it's stolen away by number 24 as he tries to beat the clock. 5 seconds remaining. Ball is stolen. Number 12 with the layup. No good. And at the half, Phoenix Redbirds are up 22-15 over the South Shore Tars. Pretty good first half so far here at the Jimmy Sanders and Sean Harrington Hall of Fame shootout at Collins Academy. Number 24 for the Phoenix has been doing everything for the Redbirds. Scoring baskets, knocking down threes, rebounding, assisting, and stealing the ball. There's nothing that he can't do. Coming up right after this word from our sponsors will be second half basketball of the Phoenix Redbirds versus the South Shore Tars here at Collins Academy, so don't go anywhere.
Where am I finna go? I'm finna just make sure everything.
No, that's. We was up in there watching the parents. This one up here is just crazy. He's there from the car. Oh, where's everybody up? Oh, yeah, we need to go. Pretty cool, this counts. Legacy, family. Legacy, look like a family. Go on, I think I'm a time.
We are back, second half action about to begin here at the Jimmy Sanders, Sean Harrington Hall of Fame Shootout, presented by Hoops High. Phoenix Redbirds are up over the South Shore Tars, 22-15, with the Tars to inbound the ball.
Come up here with that stat so I can look at it.
Come sit right here so I can see them too. South Shore is beating the Phoenix on the boards after one half, but it hasn't been able to translate to points. But South Shore opens up with the quick 2 points to start the second half. Full court press from the Tars as they look to force Phoenix Redbirds into a few turnovers. Phoenix breaks the press with no problem and swing the ball around the perimeter as South Shore falls into a 2-3. Head fake from number one, step back three, no good. Number two with the rebound for South Shore as he pushes the ball down court. Spin move by number two, dump off pass to number 11 with the free throw line jump shot. Quick 4 points from the Tars unanswered as they cut the lead to three. Number 24 takes it all the way to the basket and it's good through the contact.
You want to say something about what you say?
Number two comes off the screen, passes it to number 11, who gives it up to number 32, who loses the ball out of bounds. Phoenix Redbirds ball. And while it's still early here in the second half, the Tars are noticeably playing with a little bit more intensity, hoping to get back in this game and take the lead. The Redbirds swing the ball around the perimeter they've done for much of tonight's game. 3-point basket from number 24 is good. And that three from number 24 is his third of the night to give the Phoenix a 8-point lead with 6 minutes remaining in the second half. I'm sorry, in the third quarter. Excuse me. Number 24, bully basketball, no good, but it's fouled. And with the size that number 24 has, he just can't be stopped in the paint, so there's no reason why he doesn't use his frame a little bit more, be a little bit more physical with the ball down on the block. Number one gets the ball in the wing. Dribble, dribble, pull up jump shot. The 2-point basket is good. Phoenix takes the 10-point lead, their biggest lead of the day. Number 22 with the slasher move, blocked by number one. South Shore retains possession.
That's
pass deflected by Phoenix, out of bounds to South Shore. 5:18 remaining in the third quarter. Phoenix up 10. Ball inbounded to number 11, stolen by Phoenix Redbirds, and they're on a 3-1 fast break. Number 5 all the way, misses the layup. Offensive rebound and putback is blocked. South Shore back down court. Number 35 misses the layup. Ball knocked out of bounds on the rebound attempt. Ball stays with South Shore. Screen by number 11 at the top of the key. Traveling violation on number 2 as he tries to hop step but does it plant securely. Ball going down, Phoenix Redbirds. Free Spirit Media strives to give youth a voice so that we can inform and inspire others. Thank you so much for supporting our work. As number 2 picks up the steal and the basket is fouled and will attempt the 3-point play. Attempted his 7th point for the night. 6 points, 4 rebounds, and 1 assist on the missed free throw. Phoenix Redbirds bring the ball up as they cling to an 8-point lead here in the second half. Number 4 cross-court pass to number 1, who crosses over with the assist to number 24, who knocks down the 3-point basket to push the Redbird lead back to double digits. Ball stolen by the Redbirds, and they're off to the fast break. Number 4 takes it all the way, lays the ball in. Screen by number 11 allows number 2 to get all the way to the basket, but number 24 comes up with the block. Timeout, Phoenix Redbirds, as number 4 falls to the ground. Maintains possession. Halfway through the third quarter, and Phoenix has jumped out to a 12-point lead here to start the second half. So far, they've scored 11 points to South Shore's 6 here in the third quarter.
What you think of that? I bet you got less when you come to that.
Hoops High is a flagship program of Free Spirit Media. It is run in partnership with After School Matters, Chicago Public Schools, and CAN TV. This is a team effort all around, and we are grateful for all of our partners who make this possible. Thank you. Phoenix inbounds the ball off of the timeout. 33-21, 3:45 remaining here in the third quarter. And just walked in is Free Spirit Media's CEO, Jeff McCarter. Shout out to him in the building. Foul under the basket on Phoenix. Ball is out of bounds to South Shore.
What's up out there in TV land?
South Shore knocks down the 3 and picks up the steal off the inbound. But a foul is on number 23. And he will go to the line, number 35 for South Shore, shooting two as he looks to cut into the Phoenix lead a little bit here with two free throws. First shot coming from number 35 at the free throw line, and it's good. Second shot from number 35, and it is good. He knocks them both down. It's cut it in the Phoenix lead to just seven.
South Shore, 26.
Pass from number 11 is stolen by number 32 of South Shore. Number 12 pushing the ball down court for the Tars. Brings it back up to set up their offense. Ball is worked around the perimeter a little. Little screen and roll action from number 35 and number 11, but the ball is stolen by number 5 of the Phoenix, who takes it all the way and scores it. 35-26 for the Phoenix. 2:38 left here in the third. And the Tars just haven't been able to get anything going here tonight. None of their shots are falling. They haven't been able to take care of the ball. Just been a sloppy game from them all over. Hand check foul called on number 11 of the Phoenix. South Shore to inbound the ball on the side. Ball is stolen by number 1 of the Phoenix, who takes it all the way, but blows the fast break dunk. Just wanted it a little bit too much, didn't quite get enough elevation, and the ball will be going down to South Shore Tars. But not before the technical free throw shots coming from South Shore for the violation on number 1 for hanging on the rim. So all you kids out there watching, no hanging on the rim. If you miss a dunk, do not hang on the rim and try to get your own rebound. Just come down. Number 35 hits the tech free throw. Number 35, second shot. He hits both of the technical free throws. And don't forget to stay tuned following this broadcast for the Free Spirit Media News. It comes on at 9:50 every Saturday, and you can learn about what's going on in Chicago and find out the latest on the most important issues with teams. Number 11 with the jab step for South Shore to the basket, lays it up, no good, but it's fouled and shooting two. That is the sixth team foul on the Phoenix Redbirds. So South Shore will be shooting free throws on every foul the rest of the way here. Number 11 hits the first. The second one, just like the first one, good. South Shore cuts the Phoenix lead to just 5 with 1:45 left in the third quarter. Number 24 with the crossover dribble, but he bulldozes the defender and is called for the charge. Number 11 on the South Shore Tars sacrificing his body, and he's been doing everything to keep his team in the game, rebounding, scoring the ball, and as you just saw, taking a charge right there. Number 11 with the good string, allowing number 15 to get all the way to the basket and the layup, and the Phoenix Redbird lead is just 3 now. The defensive intensity here from South Shore in the last 3 minutes of the third quarter has allowed them to come up with another steal right there. Not only cut the lead to 3, but have a chance to get back into it. Unfortunately, they turn the ball over there. Number 24 for the Redbirds passes to number 1 in the corner, who drives baseline. Throws the ball away, and South Shore is back down court. missed the layup. Battle on the boards. Recovered by number 24. Number one, step back, fadeaway jump shot. No good. Offensive rebound, number 24. He will shoot two. Number 24 misses the first one. And he splits the free throws, pushing the Phoenix lead to four. 40 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Phoenix up 36, South Shore 32. Number 23 with the pass to the baseline. Ball is stolen by number one. 20 seconds remaining. He takes it all the way and scores it. What a nice move from the point guard of Phoenix Redbirds. Just 10 seconds remaining. South Shore with the three. No good. Rebounded by Phoenix. Just 5 seconds left on the clock. And at the end of the three, Phoenix is up 38 to South Shore 32 as we get ready for the fourth and deciding quarter. So Amari, heading into our final period, South Shore has been able to claw their way back into the game, but what are their chances of coming away with a victory here today?
Keep playing good defense, stop turning the ball over, and work our offense.
There you have it.
Move the ball around more.
There you have it, Amari Willis's keys to a W for South Shore. Keep the defensive intensity up, spread the ball around, and play great defense. If you want to see more Hoops High, now you can see the full games on our brand new website. Just go to www.hoopshigh.org to see games from the past. And in the future, you'll be able to also stream games live on your mobile device. Again, that website, www.hoopshigh.org for all your Hoops High needs. The Redbirds will inbound the ball to start the fourth quarter as they cling to a 6-point lead. South Shore starts the quarter in a man-to-man after playing zone for much of the game. Number one with the three, no good. Offensive rebound by number two, who drives baseline, dishes to the paint. Stolen by number 15 of South Shore, who goes all the way, unable to finish, but the putback from number two is good. And the Phoenix Redbird lead is just four. The full court press from South Shore is kind of making the Redbirds play a little faster today. Like, a lot of quick shots coming here in the second half. That's allowed South Shore to get back in the game. And that was just another quick shot from Phoenix, resulting in a missed shot and a rebound as South Shore looks to cut the lead to just two. Near steal by the Phoenix, but it's recovered by South Shore. And they get a layup and the foul. So number 11, who's been doing all of the dirty work for South Shore, looks to pick up a third bucket on the free throw. And he misses the free throw, so he's unable to cut the Phoenix lead to one. Pass from number one to number 23. The layup is missed. And South Shore is coming back down court with a chance to tie or take the lead here.
Travel.
The baseline mid-range jump shot is missed. But number 11 with the rebound misses the putback, but he'll go to the line shooting two. Hey. And a large part here for the Fed is giving up their double-digit lead here in the second half is they've been unable to defend without fouling. They're at their 19th foul here in the second half, almost in the double bonus as number 11 for South Shore misses the first free throw. And he splits them, and the Phoenix Redbird lead is just one, 38-37, 6 minutes and 31 seconds left in the fourth and final period. If you like Hoops High, you're sure to love Free Spirit Media. Please check out the Free Spirit Media website at freespiritmedia.org to learn about what Free Spirit Media is. And you can also check us out on YouTube. Just search Free Spirit Media to view our YouTube channel. Turnover on Phoenix as South Shore to inbound the ball on the side. The long court pass is nearly stolen, but number 32 recovers it and gets the foul, so he'll be shooting two. And with these upcoming free throw attempts, South Shore can take their first lead of the game. The first one, silky good. He misses the first, but not without getting his own rebound and tying the game up. Ball is lost out of bounds. South Shore ball. Ball is inbounded to number 11, who goes up, misses, fights for the rebound, and is able to tie up with number 5 of the Phoenix Redbirds for a jump ball. Ball out of bounds to South Shore. And South Shore has just been wanting it a lot more here in the second half. You've seen them fall behind by as many as 12, but they've clawed back into the game. Missed shot from number 2, and they've been able to tie it up. Cross-court pass from the Phoenix results in a foul on South Shore, number 32. And on the next foul from South Shore, both teams will be in the bonus for the rest of the game. Ball is inbounded to number 4. As he swings the ball to number 2 on the wing. Number 1 comes off a curl, jab step, drives baseline, misses the layup. Ball knocked out of bounds by the Phoenix, South Shore with the ball. South Shore bringing the ball up against the full court press from the Redbirds. And a turnover on South Shore gives the ball right back to Phoenix. 5:24 left here in the game, tied at 38. Phoenix with the ball, long quarter three from number 15, no good. 35 with the rebound of South Shore as they push the ball. And another turnover for the Tars. Ball going down to the Redbirds. Phoenix walking the ball up court against the full court press of South Shore. Trap on the wing. Number 1 with the ball. He drives. Picks up the foul. And we'll go to the line shooting 2. Foul is on number 32 of the Tars. The one-on-one free throw is good for number one. And he will shoot the second of the one-on-one. Second one, just like the first, good. As the Phoenix jump back out to the lead.
Whoever black truck is parked in the circle about to get towed.
Number 23 of the Tars passes the ball to number three, who lays the ball in. And we're back tied at 40. Number 24 gets the ball at the top of the key, swings it to number one on the wing, who shoots the long three, and it's good. Number one has came up big for the Phoenix in their last few possessions. And the Tars are back down court. Bounce pass coming after the foul.
Two shots.
And the Tars are in the double bonus, so they will shoot two.
Up next,
first shot from number three, no good.
Up next, game two of number 13 this weekend.
Second free throw from number three coming, and he knocks that down.
Free throw good. 43-41, Phoenix.
Four minutes left in the final period. Phoenix is up 43-41. Another long three from number one. No good, but he picks up the foul. He's fouled on the long range bomb, and he will go to the line shooting three. And you never want to foul a jump shooter. You never want to foul a jump shooter, especially when he's shooting a three. Bad defensive mistake from the Tars that could quite possibly come back to haunt him. Number one knocks down the first one. Two more coming. Second one, just like the first, it is good. And he knocks down all three, pushing the Phoenix lead to five. And again, number one has been everything for the Redbirds here down the stretch. He scored on their last three possessions, helping them regain the lead and hold on to it. Number one back down court, crossover, loses the ball, stolen from number three of South Shore, who heads back down court on the 2-1 fast break. But he turns it over. Phoenix back down court. Number one looks to take it all the way, and he finishes at the basket.
A big second half.
Steal by number one of the Phoenix. That's South Shore fouls. And number five of the Phoenix will go to the line, shooting 1-1. And again, number one for the Redbirds here tonight in this second half has been doing it all. He's scored on their last three possessions, and he's the sole reason they've been able to take back this lead here late in the game after giving up a 12-point lead here. Front end of the 1-1. It's up, no good. Offensive rebound from number four, and he picks up the foul on the Tars, and he'll go to the line shooting too. 3:23 remaining here in the game, 48-41 in favor of Phoenix Redbirds. First free throw from number four, no good. And you are watching Hoops High here at Collins Academy for the Jimmy Sanders, Sean Harrington Hall of Fame shootout. Right now you're watching the Phoenix Military Academy Redbirds take on the South Shore Tars. Phoenix has been controlling most of the game. We're up by as many as 12 here. But the Tars were able to claw their way back, even tying the game up at one point, but have fallen behind here again and are on trail 48-41 with 3 minutes and 23 seconds left here in the game. And coming up next in the Jimmy Sanders, Sean Harrington Hall of Fame shootout, we have Lynn Bloom taking on Michelle Clark right here at Collins Academy as number four misses the free throw. Final free throw coming, and it's good as he pushes the Phoenix lead to eight. The Tars will need to have some really good possessions here down the stretch if they want to have a chance at winning this game as they make another turnover. Number one with another steal and another bucket, and he's headed to the line for the three-point play. And Phoenix are back up to a double-digit lead here in the fourth quarter. The free throw is good, and we have a technical foul here on the South Shore coach. So number one will stay at the line as he also will shoot the technical foul shots. And number one of the Phoenix knocks down all three free throws. The and one and the two technical foul shots. As the Redbirds are up 54-41 with 3:13 left here in the final period. Phoenix with the ball at the top of the key. And what looked to be boiling down to a really exciting game has kind of ballooned back up to a double-digit lead. And the Phoenix get another bucket as the lead is now 15. The Tars are struggling a bit with the full court press from the Phoenix Redbird. Layup is missed by number 11, but the offensive rebound and the long three, no good. Another offensive rebound to the Tars. Foul is called on the Redbirds as number 35 of the Tars steps to the free throw line, shooting two. First free throw from number 35 is good. And both free throws are good from number 35, and the Phoenix lead is just 13 with 2:23 left in the fourth. Number 24 with the turnover for the Redbirds, and the ball is going down to the Tars. The Tars break down the full court press of the Redbirds. The three, no good. Offensive rebound to the Tars. Number 35 takes it to the basket, picks up the foul, and he'll shoot two with 2:01 left here in the fourth. Hey, First free throw from number 35 is good. And he misses the second free throw. Rebound to the Phoenix. The ball is swung to the corner for number one, who misses the three. Timeout is called, South Shore. 1:47 left here in the fourth and final period. Phoenix Redbirds up 56 to South Shore's 44. And Free Spirit Media strives to give youth a voice so that we can inform and inspire others. Thank you to all of our supporters out there. It is appreciated. South Shore will inbound the ball off of the timeout. Ball is inbounded. Number two with the Euro step, unable to finish at the basket. But number 11 of South Shore and number 24 of the Phoenix battle for the rebound, and a jump ball is called. Ball going down, Redbirds. Number one dribbles up court, is fouled by number four, and he will shoot two. First shot from number one at Phoenix is good. Second shot, just like the first, it is good. The Redbird lead is now 14 with 1:35 left in the final period. And this one is all but over, folks. Strong effort from South Shore here in the second half, but ran out of gas a little bit here. Not to mention the outstanding play from number one of the Redbirds, who's just kind of taken over this fourth quarter for the Redbirds, pushing them back to the double-digit lead. And after that last foul, number 24 for the Redbirds fouls out of the game. Strong performance from him tonight. Glass eater for the Redbirds, and he is replaced from number 22. As number 23 of South Shore shoots two. Number 23 splits the free throws. As the Phoenix push the ball down court, number one with the full court pass to number four, who lays the ball in to give Phoenix their biggest lead of the night at 15. Number 23 scores on the floater at the other end. With just 1 minute left here in our first varsity game of the Jimmy Sanders, Sean Harrington Hall of Fame shootout at Collins Academy. Long three from number two is good. 16-point lead now for the Redbirds as the clock continues to tick away. Number 11 with the easy basket. South Shore traps the ball right after Phoenix crosses half court, ties it up, gets a jump ball, and ball is out of bounds to the Tars. Ball is inbounded to number 11, who turns, lays the ball up, no good. Offensive rebound from number 4, but it's stolen away by the Redbirds. Number 22 is fouled by the Tars, and he will step to the line to shoot two. And with just 21.9 seconds remaining, this game is pretty much in the bag here. Number 22 misses the first of two. But after a really lopsided first half, South Shore came out really aggressive in the second half, was able to chop into the Phoenix Redbird lead and even tie the game up at one point. But number one of Phoenix Redbirds just kind of put the team on his back and was able to come away with a lot of clutch buckets for his team. And they will come away with the easy victory here, as number two of the Tars is fouled and will step to the line to shoot free throws. First free throw from number two of the Tars is good. Second one is also good. Redbird lead is just 13 with 10 seconds left here in the last period. And the Redbirds will dribble the clock out as they come away with the 64-51 lead. Phoenix Redbirds remain undefeated this season, coming away with the 64-51 win over the South Shore Tars, who have yet to pick up their first win of the season. Coming up next in the Jimmy Sanders Sean Harrington Hall of Fame Classic, we will have Lynn Bloom taking on Michelle Clark here at Collins Academy. You've just watched the Phoenix Military Academy Redbirds take on the South Shore Tars. And number one for the Phoenix is tonight's Hoop High player of the game. He finished the game with 16 points and 4 assists to go with 3 rebounds